So good morning all of you. Welcome to all CET aspirants as well as even Commerce Care aspirants. See, let us start with a quote, good quote, like you don't always get what you wish for, but you always get what you work for. Dear students, you understand very easily, it is in simple language, you know, you don't always get what you wish unless you do the work. See, even in mathematics, you know, you cannot get mathematics such easily. You have to work for it. The only way to improve in mathematics or to get successful in CET mathematics, you should work hard. So the meaning of this is, unless you work, your wish will not come to true. Okay, thank you. Let's go for the next slide. See, I just told you the only way to learn mathematics is to do mathematics, Paul Ahrens. See, especially in mathematics, you all know that mathematics is a phobia for many students. Even in PUC only it is phobia. Then you can think in competitive level examination how it will be there. You all know that all competitive examination questions like time based. If you go for CET, you will be having one question, 1 minute. How to solve a question in 1 minute? See, the question itself sometimes 3-4 lines will be there. You have to read the question, you have to understand the question, you have to solve the question, and you have to get the answer. That answer should be correct. See, then how much you have to practice. So you need practice, you need training, you need good teaching. So these three really will help for you. So this slide says to you that to improve in mathematics, the only way you have to do mathematics. If some students will be having like that, this question, this answer, this question, this answer, like that, they by heart like biology, but it will not work in mathematics. You have to do. Anyway, we will discuss more about this. Let me go for the next slide. This already been given by physics professor and chemistry professor of our college. You know that the examination timetable of KSET is already been announced. 28th Saturday morning session 10:30 to 11:50, it is forenoon, biology will be conducted. Afternoon 2:30 to 3:50, mathematics will be conducted. You know that it is 60 marks. And on 29th Sunday before noon, it will be conducted physics, then afternoon it will be conducted chemistry. Forenoon and afternoon, 60-60. So afternoon, those who write afternoon at 2:30 to 3:50, some students may have a habit of sleeping in the afternoon. So dear students, those students definitely will be affected in the final examination. So I suggest everyone, in the afternoon, you see 2:30 to 3:50 mathematics is there and 2:30 to 3:50 chemistry is there. These two subjects, better to write some part test and grand test in the afternoon so that you will be habituated for the final examination also. You know that CET examination is pen and paper based exam. You see under the table, pen and paper based exam. And you know, objective examination, 4 multiple choice will be there. You have to choose correct answer. Each subject will have 60 questions, and each question carries 1 mark and no negative marking. So this is only the examination which do not have negative marking. All India wise examinations like IIT, JEE, NEET are having negative marks. Luckily, KSET do not have any negative marks, so that you can attempt all the 60 questions. So I suggest, even in the last 1 minute, you have only 1 minute time. There are 10 questions left. Please fill the answers and come. Don't leave any question without bubbling, because who knows, sometimes luck also may be in favor of you. Okay, so let me go for next slide. Division of questions in CET mathematics. You know, this works in mathematics, some small deviation also will be there sometimes. from second PU itself, 45 questions will be asked. And first PU, 15 questions will be asked. So you understood now what you have to concentrate more. You have to concentrate more on second PUC because it carries more weightage. And in first PUC, 15 questions. It's like almost in first PUC, we have 15 chapters, more than 15 chapters we have. If you take the subtopics, then each topic carries 1 mark. So you have to focus much on 45 questions. That means if you are preparing for now onwards, if you count, you have really around 50 days. Out of these 50 days, you really have to work 30 days for second PUC, 10 days for first PUC, 10 days for revision. Like that, you have to plan. Next slide, I will go. Most important topics for CET, Comet K, Mathematics. These are the most important topics. This is called work smart. Why I have written here work smart doesn't mean that you should not work hard. Work hard should be there and your work smart also should be there, right? So integration itself, you will be getting 6 to 7 questions in the CET examination. So when you practice or when you prepare for CET, you give the first preference to integration, where it carries 7 marks in the final examination. Vectors and 3D almost will be having the, both are like discussion is three dimensional only, so that I can't separate vectors and 3D. Vectors and 3D are to be together. That's why in part 2 textbook, vectors after 3D chapter is there, right? So your 7 to 8 questions will be appear in the final examination of CET. You see, the more weightage which I have written on the screen for vectors and 3D. Matrices and determinants, which is one of the easiest topics in PUC, and even it is easy topic in competitive exams also, 7 questions will appear in the examination. And when you go to differentiation, nothing but continuity and differentiability. You know, part 1 textbook, this chapter is there in part 1 textbook, continuity and differentiability. From these 5 to 6 questions will appear in the exam. Sometimes, maybe 1 or 2 questions may come more also. Application of derivatives is different again. Application of derivatives is different again. That is like applications like tangents, normals, rate measure, like that. I'm not telling about that. Only differentiation will be asked 5 to 6 questions. Then another important topic is probability. 5 to 6 questions will be asked. It's roughly I have written, sometimes 1 or 2 questions may come more, may come less. My dear students, you just add all the questions. Let us take least 6 plus 7, 13, 20, 25, 30. Minimum 30 questions. That means half a number of questions will appear from these 5 topics. So this is called smart work. If you are perfect in these 5 topics, definitely you will get 30 marks. You all know that, my dear students, you all know that this year they are not considering PUC marks. Every year they used to consider 50% of the PUC marks, 50% of the CET marks. But this year they are not considering PUC because of this global pandemic. They have cancelled PU examinations. That's why your rank will be announced only through CET examination. So your preparation should be very, very hard and some work smart also. That's why I had given this slide, why you have to work smart. Whoever want to get minimum 30 marks, 30 marks is not a bad score in CET. So these 5 topics, you should be perfect. Okay. So if you take the highest weightage like 7 plus 8, 15, 22, 28, 34, nearly 34 to 35 questions will come from only these 5 topics. So you might be surprised by seeing this slide. So my dear students, you have to work smart. This is called work smart. But while doing the individual chapters, you must work hard. Dear students, let me go for next slide. how to crack KSAT examination or COMET K examination. Especially these tips, what I am giving, it is for mathematics. See, the first one, prepare concepts well and do at least one application on every concept. Dear students, what some students do, they prepare concepts well, but they don't do problems on the concepts. While doing the problems, they twist the problems. That twist you will be knowing when you are solving the problems. So on every concept, at least one application you have to do. At least one application means it may be one or two or three. Same question will be asked in a different ways. That's why how in different ways on concept, we will be discussing later about that concepts. See the second one, it's the most important one. Read the question carefully. This matters a lot when you want to achieve a fancy rank. When you want to achieve a fancy rank, this is very, very, very important point. Dear students, you know, if you get 59 out of 60 in mathematics, 60 upon 60 in mathematics, maybe the difference is one, but as far as rank is concerned, it will be in thousands. So one mark difference is in thousands in rank. So my dear students, you might be understand this very well. You see, for example, I will give you one question, one example I will give you. If you do not read concept carefully, what mistake could have been happened? Write the converse of contrapositive of the statement P implies Q. It is the question from first PUC. The topic name is mathematical reasoning. Actually, we have tried first contrapositive. You all know that contrapositive is negation Q implies negation P. And you have to write converse of contrapositive means reverse you have to write. That is the actual answer. I suggest all the students, please note down the points. What happens sometimes students may not read contrapositive in hurry. Then the answer remains Q implies P, which is the converse of the given statement. Is our answer is wrong? This was happened. Dear students, in our college, Sarangi PU College, I think I distinctly remember it may be in 2016, I think so, one girl got 59 marks out of 60. 59 marks out of 60. That girl made mistake this question. She has not read the question properly. She has not read the question properly. What she read? Write the converse. She has seen only converse, but she did not see the contrapositive. So she has taken the answer Q implies P, which remains wrong. So my dear students, I suggest everyone, please read the question carefully. This matters. Maybe you may lose one mark if you don't read carefully, but it matters a lot when you achieve a fancy rank. Well, let's go for next slide. Do not commit silly mistakes. See, very simple example by like sixth class example I give. If 2x is equal to 1, then x is equal to 1 upon 2. Student may choose the answer 2 in hurry instead of choosing 1 by 2. Yes, this happened many times. I have seen so many students. 2x equal to 1, and they will be thinking about 2x equal to 1. They finish about this question, they will be reading next question, but in their mind, 2x equal to 1, they'll tick the answer 2. But they don't pay attention. Therefore, they get x equal to 2 answer, which remains wrong answer. So, do not commit silly mistakes. You know, for IIT JEE, coaching is available in India everywhere. NEET available. Coaching is available everywhere in India. KSAT coaching is available everywhere in Karnataka. But do you have any coaching for rectifying your silly mistakes? There is no coaching for it. Nowhere in India, nowhere in Karnataka, nowhere in Davangere it is possible. You have to rectify your silly mistakes. So that how to rectify till the solution you should be carefully how to solve. Next point. Pay attention till you get the answer while solving a problem. This helps for third, how to rectify silly mistakes. Till you get the last step and till you get the answer, while solving any problem in mathematics, you pay the attention what you are doing. Your mind should work on that only. Sometimes what we do, this is easy question, let me tick the answer, let me go for this. Sometimes that time we may commit the mistake. Okay, the next one, don't try any problem more than a minute. Yeah, it kills your time. You all know that in KSET examination, one question carries 1 minute only. One question carries 1 minute only. So if you try more than a minute, then definitely your time will waste. I suggest everyone, you read the question. If you are able to solve this, if you get some idea, if you have seen such type of models while you are practicing, then you do that question. If it appears like a new question, you never see this question at all, then don't attempt that question. Go for the next question. You postpone that question for half an hour. Okay. Maybe you will be finding five or six questions like that. Then later, half an hour you can do. Next. Focus much on highly weightage topics. You have to focus much on highly weightage topics. Which are highly weightage? As I told you, you see, these are highly weightage. Integration, vectors 3D, matrices, determinants, differentiation, and probability. It doesn't mean that you should not focus on all other. That's why I said focus much, because it carries 50% of the marks of total. Next, practice all multiple choice questions given in the first and second PEC textbooks. This is the most important point, my dear students. You know, do you have first PU and second PU textbooks? Already sold out? No, I know that you will not be selling it. You see, my dear students, in every chapter of first PU and second PU, you have multiple choice questions in the exercise. You know, in every year, I am observing that there are some questions, multiple choice questions directly from PUC textbook. Even in last year, there was a question in inverse trigonometric functions directly without changing the digits he has given in IIT JEE examination. So please practice all multiple choice questions in the first and PU, second PU textbooks. Next, the point number 8. Most of the first PU questions will be in CET will be asked directly from the textbook. So as I told you, as far as weightage is concerned, from first PU, you will be getting 15 questions. All 15 questions will be asked directly. This is very, very important point. You see, my dear students, first PU, that means you read the first PU concepts very well, and in every concept, you do one or two problems. Like if you take the binomial theorem, you should know the expansion. You should know how to find middle term. You should know how to find some third term or fourth term. You should find how to find third term from the end. Like these concepts you read and do at least one question on the given concept, definitely 15 questions will be in your pocket. I have never seen a question from first PUC out of our textbook. Most of the materials you will practice in which tough questions will be there, big questions will be there from first PUC, but he is not asking like that. He is asking from textbook only. So this matter, many of the students don't know. They practice a number of materials. What is the use? Tell me. There is a small topic like limits. Entire limits will run over on two formulas only. One is limit x tends to a, x power n minus a power n by x minus a equal to n into x power a power n minus 1. Another is limit x tends to 0 sin x by x equal to 1. If you learn these two formulas and problems based on this, you can solve any question on the CET. So I suggest everyone, not only multiple choice questions of first PEC textbook, but also exercise questions also you do. Understand? Exercise questions also you practice. Similar models you can leave. Each model you practice one or two problems. And the 9th one, list all memory based formulae and revise them periodically. Yes. There will be memory based formulae. There will be shortcut formulae. You can see the 10th one. by heart shortcut formula chapter wise. See, many people say that don't by heart mathematics, you never get the marks. But I say sometimes you have to by heart the shortcuts. You tell me a plus b whole square formula, everybody remember because you have applied n number of times and you by hearted so many times. Do you know what is the proof of a plus b? A plus b whole square formula, do you know the proof? Maybe knowing or may not be knowing, but you remember the formula, you can do many problems. So chapter wise, you by heart the formula. There are formula, there are so many types. There will be shortcut formulas, you have to by heart them, and memory based formulas also you have to revise, because memory based means what? They won't be in our memory all the time. Means when you read a formula, memory based formula, there is a chance of forgetting within 24 hours. Within 24 hours you will forget. If you do not revise it, 50% you will forget. If you do not revise for 1 week, more than 90% you will forget. That's why every day morning, like chanting mantras like 5 minutes, I suggest all of you memory based formulas you revise every day. You keep some time like morning 5 to 5:30, or you can keep before going for bed also, you can do it. Okay, then by heart shortcut formula the chapter wise. Thank you. Let's go for next slide. And I think we are going to solve some problems in this session. I'm already nearly half an hour is over. Let us see some interesting problems in mathematics. This is shortcut method problem. Such a beautiful problem it is. It was asked in CET examination. This model was asked. Integral e power x into x power 5 dx. Solution is C. What is the shortcut formula I have written? You see, e power x into f of x dx equal to e power x into f of x minus f dash of x plus f double dash of x minus f triple dash of x plus so on plus c. In integration, plus c will come. You know that where f of x is an algebraic function. So whenever f of x is algebraic function, you can apply this shortcut. You see how simple solution. E power x into x power 5 dx is equal to e power x into what is f of x? X power 5. What's the derivative of x power 5? 5x power 4. Alternate signs you have to keep. What is the derivative of 5x power 4? 20x cube. What's the derivative of 20x cube? Minus 60x square. Minus 60x square, minus is an alternate sign. 60x square derivative 120x. 120x derivative 120, because x derivative 1. See how simple. Do you know, if you don't know the shortcut, how much time this problem takes? How much time this problem takes? Dear students, you have to apply UV rule. You know, if you apply UV rule, immediately answer will come. No, no. After applying UV rule, again you are forced to do UV rule. After applying second time UV rule, again you are forced to apply UV rule. That means, my dear students, to get this answer, you have to do UV rule 4 times. 4 times. Do you wish to do 4 times UV rule? No. This question will give you answer without keeping pen on the paper. Right? You need not to put pen on the paper. You can get the answer. Is it required? Instead of x power 5, you may give x power 4, x power 20. Even you can give any expression like x square plus 4, x square plus 5. Any algebraic function is there, you can apply this shortcut. So I hope you understand. Please note down this. Everyone has to note down all these problems and practice. Instead of x power 5, you replace some with algebraic function and practice. Remember, this formula will work only if f of x is an algebraic function. And e power x plus e power x only should be there. If any other function is there, we have another step. For such questions, we have different strategies. Okay, thank you. Let's go for next question. It is shortcut method problem. You see, this is a second degree non-homogeneous equation given. Ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. This is normally, we say that is a curve equation. then find dy by dx. You tell me this same question is there in our first, second view in derivatives, but instead of AB, numericals are given. If you want to solve this problem, it takes minimum more than 1 minute. X square derivative 2x, xy uv rule you have to apply, y square derivative 2y dy by dx. You can do. If you do in little bit speed, you can do still in 1 minute. No issues. But you see the shortcut which I have given. Whenever you have, whenever the given equation, curve equation or function, x and y terms are there, while finding dy by dx, you can apply this shortcut. Actually, this shortcut is taken from higher classes like partial derivatives. What is a shortcut? Minus. Differentiating with respect to x, treat y as constant. Upon differentiate with respect to y, treat x as constant. So now I want to differentiate the given equation left hand side. So treat y as constant. You tell me x square derivative 2x, that is 2x. 2hxy, as 2h is constant, y also constant. If you keep constant outside, x derivative is 1. So 2hy plus, you know that dy square derivative 0. Normally dy square derivative 2by into dy by dx, but we are treating y as constant. So dy square derivative 0. 2g externally, x derivative 1, that is 2g. 2fy, since y is constant, that derivative is also 0. C derivative is also 0. Upon, now differentiate with respect to y, treat x as constant. X square, as x is constant, derivative is 0. 2hxy, as x is constant, 2hx and y derivative 1. By square derivative 2by, as we are differentiating with respect to y, x is constant, 2gx derivative 0, 2fy y derivative 1, 2f plus c derivative 0. So what is the answer? C minus of that, the answer is given. You tell me, does it take more than a minute? No, never. Even hardly it may take 20 or 30 seconds to solve such type of problems. So my dear students, these shortcut methods are very, very important in CET, plays key role, because every problem you cannot do in a long way. While solving a problem, you try to skip few steps. Two steps, like in the air only you have to complete first step, then again you have to skip two steps and come to fourth step. In PUC method also you can do all 60 problems. I'm not telling that those who learn shortcut, they only get rank. It is false. You do in our PUC method only, but you have to do in speed. Like if generally, if the given problem has 10 steps, while solving the problem, you should do in 3 steps only, like that. Let's go to next slide. Memory based question. This is a fantastic question, asked in different competitive examinations and most expected question in CET. 0 to pi by 2 integral dx upon 4 cos square x plus 9 sin square x is equal to how much? Okay, you see the, remember this, you have to, I told you these type of formulas every day you have to by heart. I told you memory based formulas you have to revise periodically. This is like that only. You see, it is given 0 to pi by 2 dx upon a cos square x plus b sin square x equal pi by 2 ab is answer. If you do not remember this pi by 2 ab, do you know the original process for this problem? You have to divide numerator and denominator by cos square x. Then in denominator you will get a square plus b square tan square x. Numerator you will get 1 by cos square x is secant square x. Then you have to take b tan x as t and you have to solve. Again you have to change the limits. Then definitely it will take more than one minute. It is one of the example problems of our PUC textbook. Do you know if you apply pi by 2ab, how simple it is? You know, a square cos square x, instead of a square, 4 is there in our given question. A square is 4 means a is 2. B square is 9 means b is 3. Pi by 2, a means 2, b means 3, pi by 12. Will you remember this question, formula, dear students? Yes, you have to remember. See, in mathematics, there are so many shortcuts like this. Definitely, if you want the shortcuts list and all, definitely I will help. You know that I will give you my address and everything in the last. Definitely, the shortcuts in mathematics we have written separately. Then I can share with you. Okay, thank you very much. Let's go to next slide. Formula based question. This is interesting question from probability. See, A and B toss a coin alternately. The first to show ahead being the winner. If A starts the game, the chance of his winning is. It is our PUC textbook question. I have not taken it from anywhere, but the concept is same. Maybe I might have changed the question a little bit. Example question, PUC textbook. Such a beautiful question. See, blindly you apply P by 1, P upon 1 minus Q square formula. What does P stands here? Probability of getting head. You tell me when a coin is tossed. Probability of getting head is off chance. Q is probability of not getting head. Not getting head means tail. Then that is also half chance. Then substitute P value 1 by 2, Q value 1 by 2. Our answer is 2 by 3. Fourth option is right. You see, A and B are tossing a coin. Whoever gets first chance goes to head. For first chance goes to A. A started the game. Then what is the probability of winning of A? There is a question. Do you know how this formula will come and all? Everybody should know actually. By hearting is only not the skill. How the formula comes also, you should be there in your mind. Because when you finish your engineering, when you go for interviews and all, if you don't have subject, they will not give you job. They will ask the questions and sometimes they may ask, prove it. So I think if I ask how this formula comes, like P upon 1 minus Q square, many of you may not be knowing. You know, this gives like a GP series. And we have to apply infinite GP series, sum of infinite GP series formula, A by 1 minus R, then we will get this formula. But anyway, this will really help to solve these type of problems. The answer you got 2 by 3, which is winning of A. Suppose what is the probability of winning of B? If you ask, what will you give answer? What you select the answer? Winning of B. Winning of A is 2 by 3. Winning of B is out of 3 times, 2 times A will win means remaining 1 time who will win? B only will win. So the chance of winning of B is 1 by 3. Thank you. Let's go to next slide. Tricky question. Nice question. You see this one. Integral of dx by x into log x into log of log x into so on log of log x. So on log x. 8 times. In the denominator, the last term contains 8 times log. You see the options. First option, log is 8 times. Second option contains 7 times log. Third option contains 9 times log. Fourth option contains 6 times log. You see, dear students, I'll just explain you. See, solution C. Integral of 1 by x dx equal to log x plus C. And integral of 1 by x log x dx equal to log of log x plus C. It is everybody knows it. You see the second one I wrote. Integral of 1 by x 1 upon x log x. You know how to do the proof. If you log x equal to t, 1 by x equal to dt, dt by t, integration of dt by t is log t. But t is what? Log x, log of log x. You see in the denominator, second example, one log is there. In answer, two logs are there. In the first example, you don't have log. Zero logs are there in denominator. One log is in the answer. Zero logs. In answer, one log. In the question, one log. In the answer, two logs. In the similar fashion, if the question contains two logs, then answer will contain three logs. Now see the question, our question. Our question contains 8 logs. Then answer will contain how many logs? 9 logs. Very good. So the third option is right. Wonderful. Now, let's go to the next slide. The simplified form of I to the power of n plus I to the power of n plus 1 plus I to the power of n plus 2 plus I to the power of n plus 3 is. Dear students, this question is from complex numbers. Everybody knows it in first few. N, n plus 1, n plus 2, n plus 3 are consecutive terms, consecutive numbers, you know very well. Like natural numbers. You all know that I square value is minus 1. I value is root over minus 1. What is the tricky here? What is the trick here? Sum of 4 consecutive I powers is 0. That trick, if you apply, then you will get answer. Even no need to read that explanation. What does that explanation says? Put n is equal to 1. You need not put n is equal to 1. You can also put n is equal to 2, 3, 4, whatever it may be. You put n is equal to 1, then you see the given expression I plus I square plus I cube plus I power 4. So which gives I square value minus 1. I cube value, you know that I square into I square value minus 1 minus I. I power 4 is nothing but I square into I square minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. So if you add I gets cancelled, minus 1 plus 1 gets cancelled, then 0 is the answer. So such a beautiful question. Next, let us go to the next question. Next slide. Conceptual question. You see, A and B are square matrices of size n by n such that A square minus B square equal to A minus B into A plus B, then which of the following will be always true? Before reading the options, my dear students, A square minus B square equal to A minus B into A plus B is always true only in algebra but not in matrices. Actually, this formula is wrong in matrices. Then if this formula to become true, then which of the following is always true? As given one of the A or B zero matrices, A equal to B. Either A or B an identity matrices, AB equal to BA. Fourth option is right. You see the explanation. A minus B into A plus B equal to A square plus AB minus BA minus B square. You see, AB and BA, can you cancel? Can you cancel AB and BA? No, you should not cancel in matrices. Everybody knows that matrix multiplication does not follow commutative law. AB and BA you cannot cancel. Suppose if AB and BA are equal matrices, then you can cancel then A square minus B square. That means, my dear students, you see the question now. A minus B into A plus B is equal to A square minus B square. It is true only matrix multiplication is commutative, that is AB equal to BA. If AB is not equal to BA, then absolutely that formula is wrong. That expression becomes wrong. So the most important, this concept, so most of you should remember a concept here. Matrix multiplication is not commutative. Only whenever it is commutative, you have to do like this. But matrix multiplication is associative. Okay, matrices follows distributive law also, matrix multiplication. Like in functions, composition of functions is not commutative but associative. Okay, like that. Next, let me go for next slide. I hope you understood this. Please note down all these problems. This shortcut question, you see, this is from derivatives. D by dx of 3 cos x plus 4 upon 3 cos x minus 4. Dear students, to solve this problem in PUC, you have to apply U by V rule. U by V rule. If you apply U by V rule and do this problem with some speed, definitely you can solve in 1 minute. Definitely. If you do not remember formulas, U by V formula and cos x derivative, it takes some time and you will get the wrong answer. Instead of that, what shortcut formula I am applying, you see, for this will work for any of the function in the given example, you see. D by dx of a into f of x plus b upon c into f of x plus d. Then the answer is determinant of a, b, c, d into f dash f x by denominator square, c into f of x plus d whole square. Dear students, what is the a value given question? You see, in the numerator, cos x coefficient a, 3, 4, 3, minus 4. In place of f of x, cos x is there. Cos x derivative minus sin x upon the denominator square. If you expand the debt, everybody know how to expand the debt, ad minus bc. That means minus 12, minus 12. Already one more minus is there. 24 sin x is the numerator. Then option 1 is right answer. I hope you understood, dear students. This is also very, very good question, and this shortcut really will help to you. Next, we'll see one interesting question. Conceptual question. You see, the lengths of two sides of a triangle are 4 centimeters and 7 centimeters. Then what is the range of the length of the third side? My dear students, you know, this question was asked in competitive examination on that particular period. Many of the students have done this question mistake. You know, the concept of this question is in 6th class. What is the concept, my dear students? Read the concept. The length of the third side is more than the difference and less than the sum of other two sides. Am I right? Have you heard this in 6th class? Yes. Third side length is difference of other two sides, and third side length is less than the sum of other two sides. So now you tell me, what are our sides? Lengths 4 centimeters and 7 centimeters. What is the difference? 3. So it should be more than 3. And what is the sum? 4 plus 7, 11. What is the sum? 11. Therefore, our third side length should be less than sum, means less than 11. It should be more than 3, it should be less than 11. So 3 comma 11 is answer. 3 comma 11 is answer. So this concept, you know, this question came in one of the competitive examinations. Students fail to do this. He wants to test your knowledge. My dear students, I can tell you one thing. Competitive examination questions are not difficult. Remember this. Competitive examination questions are not difficult. They are just different. Different. They never be difficult. How can it be difficult? They are just different. That's all. Let's go to the next slide, my dear students. Substitution method. See, sometimes substitution makes problem very easy. You see, this is the question asked in previous year's model papers of CET. The value of 2 into sine to the power of 6 theta plus cos to the power of 6 theta minus, actually there is a small mistake, minus 3 into, not 2 into, you please note down, minus 3 into sine power 4 theta plus cos power 4 theta plus 1. There is a small mistake. Concept, you put theta equal to 0 degrees. Substitution, you have to put theta equal to 0 degrees. Then what will come? Sin 0 is 0, 0 power 6, 0, 0, cos 0 is 1, minus, I told, instead of 2, you have to keep 3, sin 0 again 0, cos 0, 1, plus 1. So 2 into 1, 2, minus 3 into 1, minus 3, plus 1, all cancel, 0 is answer. How beautiful, dear students. If you do not know the substitution method, you know how to do this question. Sin power 6 theta and cos power 6 theta, you have tried sin square whole cube plus cos square whole cube. Then you have to apply a cube plus b cube formula. Then here also, sin to the power of 4 theta, cos to the power of 4 theta, you have tried sin square theta whole square and cos square theta whole square. Then you have to apply a square plus b square is a plus b whole square minus 2ab. So nearly, definitely it will come one page solution. There is one page solution. Where is one sentence solution? See, if you need not to put theta equal to 0 degrees, you can also put theta equal to 90 degrees. You can also put theta equal to 45 degrees. Any angle you put, because trigonometry problems are based on angles only. So it is not true for only 0 degrees. Any angle you put, answer will come 0 only. Thank you, dear students. We have seen 10 different questions. We have seen substitution questions, concept questions, memory based questions, shortcut questions. So I think definitely some suggestions you have received from my side and wonderful problems, some concepts also you might have learned. Let us go to the next slide. See, dear students, number of questions appeared in CET 2019 chapter wise mathematics. This is very, very important. It is in 2019, have taken as 2019 question paper and I did it. In 2021 also, obviously it will be the same. Okay. So, whichever the year you take, one or two questions less and more will be there. But this table 90%, 99%, this table is true. From second PUC, if you take relations and functions, you will get three questions every year. Inverse trigonometric functions, two questions. Matrices and determinants, seven questions. See, that's why I have given this highly weightage topic in important. Continuity and differentiability, six questions. Application of derivatives, five questions. Integration, six questions. Application of integration, three questions. Vectors, four questions. 3D, three questions. Vectors and 3D together, seven questions. Probability, four questions. Linear programming, one question. You know, linear programming means LPP. In LPP, 1 6 marks question will come in the PU examination. But unfortunately, I have not written PU examination, but you might have practiced graphs. You may ask, sir, how the question will be asked in graphs for 6 marks? You need not to draw the graph. Just you will learn how to draw the graph, how to plot the graph, and finding the feasible region and finding the corner points. Like that, you will ask the questions. It is easy questions only will ask. In linear programming problem, one problem is there in our textbook, second PUC, part 2 textbook, one multiple choice question is there. Please practice that question. That question is important in case of examination. Let's go to next slide. These are the number of questions appearing in second PUC. First PUC, if you take sets, one question will come. Relations and functions, one question. Normally, what he will ask in these relations and functions, he may ask domain of the function or range of the function. Remember, he may ask domain or range. Then mathematical reasoning, one question. We have already seen mathematical induction also, one question. Menomil theorem, one question. Sequence and series, one question. Straight lines, one question. Conic section, you know, it's the biggest topic in which circles is there, parabola is there, ellipse is there, hyperbola is there, all together one question. But sometimes he may increase one question in that. Permutations and combinations, one question. Trigonometry, two questions he asked. Trigonometry, two questions means in trigonometry, again trigonometric equations is there. There one question. Linear inequalities, one question. Limits and derivatives, one question. Mostly we will give question from limits because derivative extension is, derivatives extension is there in second PU. Statistics, one question. Introduction of 3D, this is very, very important, one question. What is introduction of 3D means about quadrants, images, ratios, internal division, external division, that you may ask. Complex numbers and quadratic equations, one question. My dear students, you see, in 2019, 16 questions were asked. 16 questions were asked from first PUC. We believe or not, all from PU textbook directly. If you want, you can open CET 2019 paper. Maybe numerical changes will be there. So my dear students, what I suggest to you, please practice first PU textbook thoroughly. Then you will, you need not to have any coaching. Don't go to any coaching center for first PUC. For second PUC, you may take the coaching, but first PUC, you need not have any coaching. Take the textbook and solve each and every problem related to one concept. Then definitely we get the 16 marks. Oh, this is very, very important slide we have seen. Let me go to next slide. Method of preparation for mathematics for CET. First point is speed and accuracy is very important. You have to solve the problem in speed, very speed and accuracy. If you do speed and if you occur with wrong answer, there is no use. So speed and accuracy is very, very important. Following multiple materials will not make you perfect. So choose a suitable material and follow it. Many students, what they do, they keep n number of books on the table. They feel that at the end of the day, oh, so many books are there. I have studied so much. Even they do some like to satisfy somebody, they keep so many books on the table. I'm not blaming whoever keeps so many books on the table, but my suggestion, what is my suggestion? Instead of going to different materials, take one material, whichever the material, because all the materials contain same content, 90% same content will be there. So practice that one material thoroughly. You will purchase 10 mathematics books and you will not be perfect in any of the book. What is the use, my dear students? Take one book and solve it thoroughly. Definitely will get good marks. Next, solve more number of problems to make yourself perfect in concepts. Yeah, physics people say that you should be perfect in concept, but mathematics people say that to be perfect in concepts, you have to do more number of problems on that. You must attend part test, dear students. See, you had practiced so many problems. Then if you don't test yourself, then what is the use? This fourth and fifth point are very, very important. Attend part test. What is meant by part test? Suppose if you take mathematics, we divide into four parts: algebra, trigonometry, differential calculus, integral calculus, geometry. Five parts are there. On every part, you take one test. Geometry, you take one test. Differential calculus. Differential calculus means from functions, limits, derivatives, continuity, differentiability, application of derivatives. On that, you take one test. After you are perfect in part test, then you go for grand test. Grand test means complete syllabus. 10 grand test, minimum 10 grand test you have to write. You know, each grand test contains 60 questions, in which 45 from second PUC, 15 from first PUC. Then you, dear students, 10 grand test into 60 questions, 600 questions. My dear students, if you practice 600 questions in mathematics, how the question will miss, how the concept will miss in final examination? So while solving this 10 grand test, you have to note the concept also. You have to note at the end of the solving the problem. Okay, the next slide will go. Dear students, we came to conclusion. A goal without a plan is just a wish. Yeah, you suppose you want to plan, you are planning to get good marks in CET and Comet K, but you did not make any plan. This I told you, this 50 days you have to plan like this. 30 days you have to practice for second PUC, 10 days you have to practice for post PUC, and you have to write remaining 10 days, 3 days you go for part test and 7 days you go for grand test. Work hard for 16 hours per day, then definitely you will achieve high fancy rank in KSET examination. You see, if you want to become doctor, if you want to become topper, then that is your dream. The dream which you want to become topper should not allow you to sleep. So if you get to, by the end of the day, when you go to bed, you should calculate what I did today, where I have wasted the time, did I utilize the time, did I read 16 hours today. Suppose here I am wasting, using mobile I have wasted time, I am talking to friends or chatting to friends, I have wasted time. So like that, you calculate every day before you get to sleep. You dear students, if you work hard that particular day, then definitely your sleep will be very good. If you waste, then if you revise everything, you won't get sleep. So my dear students, the dream to become topper of CET should not allow you to sleep. And my dear students, thank you and all the best for your CET and Comet K examination. Myself, I am Jagan Mohan Rao, HOD of Mathematics, Sarami PU College. We have two branches. One is at Davangere and Shivamogga. In both the institutions, I'll be handling mathematics. And I wish you once again all the best for your examination. Once again, I am very much thankful for management of BIT Engineering College and whomever given this opportunity. I feel very much great. I am proud of myself for being presenting in this seminar. Thank you very much. Thank you, Varandal.